follow us, please keep on letting us know that you're there. May your comments and your sharing will be a blessing to many others. There are those that have come here, men of God and servants of God in this land and other places. We want to appreciate you. Apostle sir, we have delegates even from Kisumu. Kisumu brethren, please stand. Brother Bramwell and his team, the wife, and their friend, Grace. Is it Grace? All the way from the county of Kisumu. These ones. These ones decided they are not going to do mandamano. They decided to come and be impacted in the house of God. You are most welcome. We appreciate you coming all the way. And they just came for the conference. And they never miss when Apostle is here. We appreciate you. I think we can appreciate them one more time. Right. So allow me to acknowledge quickly other men of God that are here with us. We have Pastor Julius Babu from Arise and Shine. From Arise and Shine. He is here. Please let's appreciate the man of God. We have Pastor Joshua. Pastor Joshua from Everlasting Glory. He's here. Let's appreciate him. Then we have Pastor Jane Wahome. Also, is it Jane? James, that is James. I think somebody wrote in a very interesting way. So yes, Pastor James, thank you so much. Thank you so much. That is ICC Meru. Thank you for coming. We appreciate you indeed. Pastor Raphael, my son, is also in the house, EAPC. We have Pastor Frederick M, EAPC also. Milimani, he's in the house. And we have Pastor, is it Jared or Jano? Gekunda from PEFA. Thank you, sir. We appreciate you. Thank you for coming. You are in the right place. We also have Pastor Patrick, Patrick Moraithi from Egoji. Pastor Evans is in the house. Reverend Veronica is in the house, please. I thought you are going to stand. The sons and daughters of this house. I thought when I mentioned Reverend Veronica, you are going to stand and appreciate the Lord. Even though you are still not standing. Not apostle. Naona kama nitawaitia apostle Moses. Apostle, so much has happened since you were here last year, and every moment we have an encounter with you is always a moment of encounters with God. The kind of investment you have done in our lives is indelible. We are so grateful for the ministry impartation. Last year, when you were here, we had not gone to elections. Now we were able to go to elections, peaceful elections. Now we have a new president in this country. Peacefully. Let's appreciate the Lord for that. Then, in the course of time from last year, remember that last year, for the last like 3 years, this country has gone through a very terrible drought. Animals were dying, some people are dying. But now the Lord has given us rains. Let's appreciate the Lord for his goodness. Amen. I'm mentioning that because Apostle has a special assignment and mandate, and he loves the country Kenya, and he prays for us as a nation, as a people, and much more, the commission of GGV. He's in the forefront praying for us and encouraging us. And every moment you're here, sir, is always a moment of impartation of wisdom. We are ready again this week. We love you together with your family back in Uganda, your wife, Ivana, and Evangelist Judah. You know, we had a fellowship this morning, and Apostle was telling me how the two are really competing for him. That is, they are not having enough of him because the young man is feeling like he should be the one. Then the queen is also feeling she should be the one. Thank you, sir. We really appreciate your sacrifice to be with us. And we are ready the whole of this week, the lunch hour services, the evening services, all the way to Sunday. Those men of God that are here, we want to appreciate you, because every time Apostle is here, he has a word across the board for business people, for ministers of the gospel, for mothers, for fathers, for leaders, everybody. There is a way God has helped his servant that is able to rightly divide the word, and you shall receive something. Without further ado, I want us to be upstanding. It's going to be a moment of experience with God. Lift up your hands and say, in the name of Jesus, Father, I am ready for the message and for the messenger. I receive the messenger and the message, a sent word to heal me and to deliver me, to bring light and understanding. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, we put our hands together for Jesus as we receive Honorable Apostle Richard Mayanja.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
We give you the keys of Meru County. May your Holy Spirit cover the sky of this region and beyond. We give you the keys of Kenya. Let this meeting cause a revival in this country. Whoever will hear this message will completely say that surely the Lord has spoken to me. Let there be a change in the atmosphere and the realm of the spirit. Let the devil loose. You sent me from Uganda. Help me to change the news of this country concerning the body of Christ in this land. Let the people know that there is still a living God in heaven. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated on the head of your enemies. What a joy and a pleasure for me to be back to this great family. I always look forward to coming to Meru. Meru has been like an headquarter for Apostle Mayanja's messages. You better call for yourself. I meet people who tell me that I got this message from Meru. That is important. So we thank God for a man like Bishop Dr. Kariuki for accepting the call of God, because as long as he's here, the nation and other people are able to hear the message. So I appreciate Bishop one more time. And now I appreciate Reverend Veronica for being a powerful pillar in this household of faith. When I ask about them, I don't finish until I've asked them about their children. And I love you people so much, so much. We are praying for you. There is a lot of prayer going on. Some of my friends, the people are praying, they want us to see God in this meeting. They are praying that you will leave this place not the way you came. Amen. Whisper to your neighbor and say, my new neighbor, you will not leave this place the way you came. Amen. Look to another person and say, my new neighbor, it was your business to come in this place, but your living here will be God's business. Amen. So it is going to be extreme. It is going to be powerful. The Lord sent me to take you deeper, very deep. Amen. So make sure you bring everybody to the house of God. Tell them, I'm taking you to church, dead or alive. Your resurrection will happen in the sanctuary. Even when you are dead, be here. Praise God. I appreciate all the pastors and the men of God who have come. Please clap for the servants of God. And receive greetings from my very powerful family. Amen. Isn't God wonderful? We are going to have a wonderful moment in this house of God. I'm going to take you through a few things. Are you ready? Say, I'm ready. Are you sure? Are you sure? Okay. Good boy. Hallelujah. I was telling Bishop to fathers of this country, the first caliber, the cream, de la cream of the fathers in this land, they started their ministry in Uganda. Actually, they had settled in Uganda. Some of the big denominations we have in Uganda, they were started by them. In fact, people like, men of God like Dr. Joe Kyle, have you ever heard of that name? He was in Uganda. He married from Uganda. Men of God like Dr. Arthur Kitonga was in Uganda. They were all actually doing ministry in Uganda before they came here. Men like Dr. Mutua, the spiritual father of Bishop Lai, the one of Machakos, men like the late Bishop Charles Moyo, all that cream of the fathers of Pentecostalism here. They left Uganda when Idi Amin came to power. The only one who didn't marry from Uganda was Bishop Kitonga. The mama was telling me this because when they were coming, she was already part of the man. The rest, we gave them wives. So I was telling Bishop today that I usually tell those fathers that I'm now their harvest. I also came to Kenya, the way they came to Uganda, and I also scooped a girl out of Kenya. That works well. Amen. I think that is a good deal. Amen. Someday I harvest. When I look back, I can't believe I've preached to you 14 years. Time can fly. But what makes me believe is the first time I came here, Wanda was a very tiny girl. Now she's at the university. That tells me I've been around Meru for some time. Praise God. Jamila was born, I think. You were pregnant with Jamila, or she was newly born? Eesh. Clap for me now. I have labored. I have labored in this land. Amen. And I'm still going to labor until I see you arrive in your destiny. This is just but the beginning. So we are going to go through some things. There are things I don't do in other ministries, but I do for you here. Like I no longer preach in lunch hours, but tomorrow I'll be here, lunchtime. So bring somebody, we share something from the mouth of God. I'm bringing a message. Let me look at my stuff. And you become an apostle. I saw an ordination here of pastors. The reason why they are not drinking is because they are not yet apostles. Clap for the apostle as he drinks. So, I told you, most of the time you are the first recipients of my messages. I don't know how it happens. Like this one, I've not preached it anywhere since I was created. And we are here. It is going to be a message we will go through in the evenings. How many of you want to be spiritual? You know, we no longer have so many spiritual people. People are carnal. People have decided to be carnal. You're not a carnal person. When they meet you, the first thing they will ask you, what car does your pastor drive? When you hear such people, just know they are very carnal. A spirit-filled person, a spiritual person, they don't ask some of those questions. They are more interested in the depth of the spirit that is in your ministry. Amen? I want to teach you that you should have things, but don't allow things to have you. It's okay to have things, but it is not okay for things to have you. You can have a jet and look like you don't have any. I've met some real wealthy people. The guy you know is rich, but he doesn't even mention anything about his money. You meet him, he's so interested in hearing what you are going to say. Have things. Don't allow things. Actually, that is the easiest way to have things. When God sees that you have reached a level of not allowing things to have you, he will allow things to come to you. The scripture is clear. It says, these blessings shall pursue you and overtake you. They pursue. You don't pursue them. Every time you try to pursue the blessing, it will speak back to you that you are breaking the protocol. I'm told to pursue you. Don't pursue me. Your responsibility is to pursue God. As you pursue God, you meet gold. Are you hearing me? But when you pursue gold, you miss God. Very important. Now, I want to help you for the first time in this country to teach this. I'm going to teach you 10 habits to boost your spirituality. Now, Meru County, you better clap better than that. Because whoever will ever speak about this message, you will tell them, you must have heard it from us. 10 habits. Everything that has become a habit, it started as an action. Nobody was born a gossiper. You start slowly with, have you heard? Have you heard? You start slowly and say, this is between me and you. Before you know it, you realize it wasn't between you and him. It was between you and everybody. There is nothing that you can become without practicing it. Now, I want you, my friends, to start practicing holiness, spirituality. And they tie you on the leg of Richard, you will go everywhere you want to go. Because she would call for me and she couldn't find me. I come back in the evening. Whenever I visit my grandmother, the problem was that my mother and my dad come from the same village. Now you can imagine, we had so many relatives, the entire village, they are all our relatives. So you can't find me. But when I became a man, I threw away childish things. Today, I'm one of the introverts you will ever meet in life. I believe in being alone. I'm a loner, and I don't get bored. I talk less. I don't get bored. I can be in the hotel, apart from when you pick me or when I'm going to maybe the gym, but you cannot find me in the restaurant talking. I'm a loner. I have practiced that, and it works for me. Let me say, great people are loners. Are we live on radio and YouTube and Facebook? Awesome. I'm the happiest man on earth now. Praise God. Great people are loners. Never forget that. Not everyone is going to go with you where you want to be. Where God wants to take you, there are people who are supposed to live your life, whether you like it or not. You will never reach your destiny with everyone. There is a place for loneliness in this life. Jesus went to the cross alone, not with the multitudes, not with the apostles. Alone. Destiny is a lonely journey. When I should not hear that again. Yeah? When Abraham was going to sacrifice Isaac, in the beginning, he was with boys, servants. They don't even tell us the number. But they tell us his servants, even the donkeys. Can you imagine even the donkeys were walking with Abraham to destiny? Some donkeys must live your life. Some of you are stuck because you have allowed donkeys to go with you to your destiny. I curse every donkey out of your life. Donkeys are stubborn. You don't need stubborn people around you. Every donkey this year is living your life. Hallelujah. So even the donkeys were going with Abraham. But the Bible says when he saw a mountain from afar off, he looked at everyone minus the sacrifice. He said, now guys, you stay here with the donkeys. It is only I and the Lord who will go yonder and worship and will come back to you. There is a place called yonder where you cannot go with everyone. Amen. May God help you to be a loner. Actually, the greater you become, the more lonely you become. Because you realize that people don't see what you are seeing. So instead of speaking, you decide to be quiet. You can meet people discussing things, and you just feel like you cannot fit in this conversation. You just walk away. And that is not pride. That is spirituality. 10 habits, by the time we will get to 10, I swear to you, some donkeys will not be with you. Are you ready? Oh, tell your neighbor, my new neighbor, now fasten your seatbelt. 10 habits to boost your spirituality. Number one, these are things you have to do every day. Every day, number one, are you ready? Every day, spend time with God in the morning. In the morning. Every day. I said when? In the morning. The morning starts from midnight. So from midnight down, do that in the morning. You know these things, after when you practice them, they will become normal. At home, I can walk from the living room, I go to the bedroom, speaking in tongues, and thinking that I'm just going to take like 15 minutes. It is a habit at home. They don't even bother me. They realize that when I started speaking in tongues at around 10, I didn't go to bed. I finished at 6 in the morning. I don't prepare to speak until morning. I just start. It is in me now. A pastor friend of mine was asking me last week. He called. I had his money. I told him, I need to give you this money. So he didn't come. So he wanted to call me in the morning. And he said, I think Apostle might be not ready for me at this time. And when he called, I told him, you were right because I had an overnight. He said, where? I said, alone. He said, do you still have that energy? That's what he was asking me. Apostle, you still do overnight prayers alone? I said, you see, the way you get it is the way you keep it. The way you get something is the way you keep it. In the morning, it is not easy. From 6 in the morning, I don't receive calls a lot. I only leave my phone in silent to see who called me. Then I return the calls because I sleep in the morning. It is actually harder for me when I travel because my culture doesn't change. So it is really hard for me when I travel because I have to preach in the evenings. I get tired. And yet my body is wired to sleep in the morning. So it is really hard. It's really hard. This morning I told Charles I will not go to the gym because I knew I came yesterday, but still my body is wired to sleep in the morning. You understand what I mean? Praise God. Ivana woke up the other day and she had me move in the house. 2:33. Ooh, I'm speaking. She opened, came from her bedroom and said, Daddy, why are you still working? I said, what is the problem? Go back to bed. She likes knowing so much about me. She will know. She shouldn't worry. She's going to be a powerful preacher. She will know. Amen. She's learning by observation. By the way, my books will be here tonight. So tomorrow we'll have them here. Praise God. Habits. Somebody say habit. Habit number one, I said, every day, spend time with God in the morning. There is a reason why I've said in the morning. Because the morning is important to God. When you wake up before you do anything in the morning, not 7 in the morning, I'm talking of real mornings. Are you listening? I want to see you wake up at 3 in the morning. 4. Don't start from where I am. At least pick a morning for you. A real morning that will show God that you are sacrificing something. The Bible tells us that we should give to God our first fruits. Now I'm starting to preach. And that means the first fruits of the day should go to God. That's why the midnight hour is an important hour. Because it is the first fruit of the day. When you offer the morning to God, God will know that you really love Him. Spiritual people, real spiritual people, they know how to rise in the morning when it is still dark. And they lift their voices to God. Since you love scriptures, because I'm seeing your faces are saying, Apostle, when are you reading the Bible? Let me go. Psalm 5, verse 2. Or let's read from verse 1. Let's read from verse 1. Give ear to my words, O Lord. Consider my meditation. Give heed to the voice of my cry, my King and my God. For to you I will pray. Let us read verse 3 together. My voice you shall hear in the morning. O Lord, in the morning I'll direct it to you and I will look up. Stay there. My voice. Before you say hi, hi, before you go to Facebook, before you go to any other social media platform, the first person who should hear your voice should be God. Before you speak to any other person, look up. Practice every day to spend time with God in the morning. Read that verse again for me. My voice you shall hear in the morning. This is David. Oh Lord, in the morning I will direct it to you and I will look up. Now we wonder why people like David were so close to God. We wonder why God loved them. This is one of the secrets of King David. His first thing to do when he wakes up early in the morning, God should be the first one to hear my voice. It works. You can't make God number one and God then makes you number 55. What you sow is what you reap. You make him first, you will be first always. David is the only king among the kings who have lived on this earth who will rule with Jesus when the Lord comes back in the millennial reign. They will sit together in Jerusalem, the city of David. You see, when you make God number one, everything you do, make sure that it will have a long-lasting impact. Come on now. Is anybody listening to me? I feel his presence now. Whatever you do, when you make God number one, he makes sure that you have a long-lasting impact. We have had nations come and go. Empires have come and gone. Just the other day, in Israel, they were celebrating the 4,000 years of the city of Jerusalem. It has been there for how many years? 4,000 years. And how do they call it? The city of David. When you make him number one, when you do that, whatever comes out of you, your efforts will be long-lasting. How many of you want your labor to be long-lasting? Their cities, they talk to us, they are no more. Where is Mesopotamia? Zero. You are reading about, and that is why they feed our children, things that don't exist. No wonder we are where we are. Things that don't exist at all. Are you listening to me? When you honor God this way, when you develop such a habit, what comes out of you will be long-lasting. Amen. God will bless the generation and the seed that came out of you. Every man of God was a great man. We are early risers. Abraham never sacrificed to God later in the day. But we hear, in the morning, very early in the morning. There's something about very early in the morning. Train yourself that way. How many of you want to be spiritual? The reason I think why God wanted me to preach this message in Kenya this time is because of the attacks on the body of Christ. The Lord told me, go there and take them deeper. Deeper. By the time they will try to shake you, you will be like a rock. Listen to me. It doesn't matter which cult is rising up in Kenya. Jesus said, I will build my church and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. It's not a fast cult. We had one in Uganda where 800 people were banned in the church, and the church of Jesus Christ is still alive and well. No weapon that is formed against the church of Jesus Christ shall be able to prosper. Every mouth that is speaking for the downfall of the church, that mouth will go. The church will stay. Hallelujah. Clap for the church of Jesus. Shout, we are here to stay. You didn't shout. Shout, I'm here to stay. Idi Amin closed the born again churches in Uganda in 1972. 7 years later, Idi Amin was not in Uganda. The church was still in Uganda. Idi Amin was buried in the sands of Saudi Arabia. The church in Uganda is still alive and well. No weapon that is fashioned against the church of our Lord Jesus. Come on, clap to Jesus. He's alive and well. I'm Richard Mayanja, and I approve those words. Oof. Don't make me start. Hallelujah. Praise God. The cults will go. The church will stay. That is the Bible. That is what I learned that from a professor in the Bible called Gamaliel. Gamaliel was saying to the Sanhedrin when they wanted to close the church, he said, men and gentlemen, listen. A few years ago, there arose a man called Judas. And Judas looked like a prominent man. He had 400 followers. He's no more. And he told them, if what these people are doing is not of God, it will not stand. But if it is of God, you might be fighting with the hand of God. That is what Gamaliel told me. Hallelujah. Okay, let us go back. Let us leave Malindi alone. Oh, is it Malindi or Kilifi? Kilifi alone. My voice you shall hear in the morning. Is somebody getting something already now? In the morning, be the first to talk to God. What a privilege. When others are beginning to talk to him at 9 o'clock, you would have spoken to him already. You will see a scripture that will make your knees have fellowship with one another. But let's go, let us go. My voice, let us read that verse again. My voice, in the morning, I will direct it to you, not to any other person. The first voice, the moment you open your mouth in the morning, the voice, your voice should be directed, number one, to God. Not, honey, good morning. Hi, baby. Come on. Don't baby me. Let me talk to God now. You baby me later. Sweetie, mango. Woo, they love me in Meru. I will direct it to you and I will look up. You want another scripture? You can't say no. Psalm 143. We are reading from verse 8. Cause me to hear. Come on now. Cause me to hear your loving kindness in the morning. That's the beauty of it. For in you do I trust. Cause me to know the way in which I should walk. For I lift my soul to you. Wait, stay there. There are some things God cannot speak at 3 in the afternoon. He speaks them in the morning. And David knew that. He says to God, can we read it together like we had breakfast? cause me to hear your loving kindness in the morning. Lift up your hand and make it a prayer point. Say, Lord, cause me to hear your loving kindness in the morning. Okay, now start reading it again as a prayer point. Go ahead. 1, 2, 3, go. Cause me to hear your loving kindness in the morning. For in you do I trust. Cause me to know the way in which I should walk. If I lift up. That means you cannot be disappointed in the day if you have done this. Lord, cause me to hear your loving kindness in the morning. The best news of heaven is released in the morning, not in the afternoon, not at 2 o'clock. Cause me to hear your loving kindness in the morning, for in you do I trust. Cause me to know the way in which I should walk. When you pray like that, you can never stand in the wrong place during the day. Cause me to know the way in which I should walk. For I lift up my soul to you. Okay, the following verse says, deliver me, O Lord, from my enemies. In you I take shelter. Such prayers are effective in the morning. Teach me to do your will. You can only learn to do your will in the morning. For you are my God. Your spirit is good. Lead me in the land of uprightness. Every day, spend time with God in the morning. It should be a habit. That is a habit that boosts our spirituality. When you practice that, we will see the change in you. We will just realize you are very spiritual. Something has happened. We would just say, you know, when someone is spiritual, when you carry a presence of God, everyone wants to be around you because there is that thing that attracts them to you. I saw a fight in this country. I will not mention the town. I was hosted by a very wealthy man, very wealthy. He came where I was preaching and he requested the bishop that he would love to host Apostle Mayanja for dinner. I don't like going to people's homes. There are two places I don't like going to. People's homes and people's businesses. I don't want to visit your business. I'm not a hawker. I'm a loner. So it was a struggle, but eventually I accepted. So when I went there, hey, how did you get here?
You move like, is this one on?
Yes, sir.
Wait. Do you want to hear my strong Swahili? You will get lost when I speak Swahili now. Hear this. So I accepted. When I went there, set her. Usually I'm scared. When I look at food, I get scared. Believe me, food scares me. There are two things that scare me. One of them is food. Another one, I don't like looking at women crying. They scare me. Even when I want to pass judgment, and they begin to cry, I feel intimidated. I don't want to see women cry. So food scares me. One preacher, they were laughing at me. They said, hey, Apostle, you hate food. No, I don't hate food. I just get scared, especially when it is too much. But there are things that I enjoy. There are things that I enjoy. For example, I enjoy seeing someone eating a lot of food. That one can make me sit there and just watch. They bless me. They bless me. There are some people who enjoy. Sometimes I ask God, why didn't you give me this kind of appetite? A guy can eat everything on the buffet. Hey! What a ministry. So, I accepted to go. When we sat on the dining, the son of this man came and sat next to me. I tell you, when you carry something spiritual, there is something that attracts people around you. I saw a fight in the house. The father fighting with his own small boy. You are not supposed to sit next to Apostle Man. I'm the one sitting next to Apostle Man. I was looking at the dad like this. I was like, leave the boy alone. The boy had to leave. So then they sat down. When he sat down, he was like, you don't know what I'm feeling. I said, what do you feel? I feel peace, like I have no problems on us. When you are spiritual, people forget food and they just want to sit next to you. You guys, I'm about to punish you. You took my microphone and you are disturbing me. You should edit what I'm saying now. Don't do it. Huh? Don't try. Be spiritual, but not over spiritual. I know you want to do the best for me. Leave me alone. Listen, let me drive my thing home. It is my first time to preach this message. Amen? When you are spiritual, there is something about you beyond a car. People just want to be around you. Have you ever met such people? A person you meet, he doesn't have much, but he's too spiritual. You just love being around them. Amen? Just love being around them. Praise God. Which scripture did I read? I want to hammer you with another one. Aki. Lamentations chapter 3 verse 22. Through the Lord's mercies we are not consumed, because his compassions fail not. Verse 23. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. That scripture turned my life around. Somebody read that verse for me. There. I want to hear your voices. Speak it louder than that. What is new every morning? The mercies of God. They are new every morning. What does it mean? This is what the Holy Spirit spoke to me, Bishop. There are so many people who are depending on last year's mercy because they don't know how to stand before God in the morning. The mercies of yesterday, they cannot help you today. The mercies of God are new every morning. The Lord told me some time ago that you should learn to stand in my presence to collect the mercies for the day. Are you listening? This is getting hotter now. The mercies for the day. There are so many of you who are seated here who have not enjoyed the mercies that God released upon this day, because you woke up at 11. His mercies are new every morning. That alone can make you stand before God early in the morning. Go and collect the mercies for the day. When you are praying in the morning, tell God, I'm here also to receive the mercies you have released upon this day. You will see how your life is going to change drastically. You wouldn't be where you are if you understood this. His mercies are new every morning. They are not new every evening. They are not new every afternoon. They are only new. They are released in the morning. You need to know the time zones of God, or else you make a prayer that will never be answered. You want God's mercy? He releases it in the morning. Stand before God in the morning to collect new mercies from God. How many of you promised the black preacher that from today you will stand before God while it is still dark in the morning? Please do it for yourself. Do it for your children. Do it for your grandchildren. Do it for your destiny. Leave everyone alone. Don't care who doesn't wake up. This is a lonely journey. Are you listening to me? God is where God is taking you is not where he's taking everyone. So forget about people. Don't wake them up unless you have agreed to form a WhatsApp group that you decide to wake up each other very early in the morning. Stand before God. Collect the masses for the day. Make it a habit. So now you are crying to us. You woke up very late when the angels that dispatch masses in the morning had already left. Don't rely on yesteryear's masses. Every single day of the week, God releases new masses. Last year, he gave you a car. This year, he wants to give you a more. You didn't hear me. That's why you didn't say amen. Your amen is still sick. Your amen is suffering from Ebola. Are you listening to me? Please, promise me that you will stand before God to collect the masses for the day. They are new every morning. That means 365 days a year, each day has its own masses. See what you've been missing? Each day has its own masses. Yesterday, someone gave you transport. That was the masses for that day. Today, the masses God wants to release is for someone to pay school fees for all your children. Go and stand before God very early in the morning to collect the masses for that day. Do you understand the black preacher? Clap for yourself now. Every day, stand and spend time with God in the morning. We read what? Lamentations. You see that one? Imagine that one was found in Lamentations. As of you don't want to read Lamentations, now you know. The mercies of God. I knew every morning, and we got that from where? Lamentations. Good. This one has a lot of scriptures to convince you. Psalm 30 verse 5. For his anger is but for a moment. Read it with me. For his anger is but for a moment. I can't hear you. For his anger, his favor is for life. Somebody shout favor. Shout favor. Okay, let us wait, see when he releases that favor. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes. Woo-hoo! I don't know whether you feel what I'm feeling. Favor. God has not promised disaster in the morning. Weeping will endure just for a night. But joy. never found in his speech. I've never. This man, I don't know whether he thinks before he speaks. He's very careful. I think in Kenya he ranks number one in that line. I've met preachers. I'm a friend of many preachers, but some preachers disappoint me. They are just crazy. They're just crazy. They talk things, and I feel like, what can I do to this man? This one knows how to compose himself. I've been with him for years, but I've never found fault in his mouth. That is powerful. In fact, I thought about it today and I prayed for you. God has to bless this man. He has to bless him. He has to bless him. He has to bless him. There are people who are not careful. In other words, they are not spiritual. You know, we don't have many spiritual people nowadays. We have believers. But let me tell you, it's not enough to be a believer. It is not actually enough to come to church. You know why? There is a scripture that shocked me. When Philip went to Samaria, in Acts, I think, 8, he went 8 or 9, he went to Samaria, there was a great move of God. And the Bible says, there was a man. Do you remember the witch doctor? What was his name? Simon. The Bible says he also got saved and he was baptized. The witch got born again. No, he was baptized. But later we see that he was not born again properly. He got saved, but he wasn't spiritual. So not just because people come to church, that doesn't mean they are spiritual. No, they are not. There are many people who come to church, but they are not spiritual. May God bring back spirituality in church. Because that is what makes a difference. It's not a building. It is not a house I live in. It is the spirituality, that thing. Christ in us. The hope of glory, that thing now. Are you listening, my brother from Kisumu? You are listening. You came with who? Beautiful. Hey, clap for my Kisumu guys. Okay? Joy comes when? Now, I don't know, but I prayed for you.
Hallelujah to my spiritual eyes. To understand what the Spirit is like. That there is something you miss in the morning.
In the morning. These people say, me, I love my sleep, my friend. He gives sleep to his beloved, but not in the morning. Not in the morning, sir. Not in the morning. Wake up in the morning. If you were a preacher, how many preachers are here? Stand on your feet. If you were a preacher and you want to see a vibrant ministry, be an early riser. Don't allow anybody. Your members should not talk to God before you talk to God. Be the first. When you are the first, you will never be the last. That's a simple, you know, I've discovered that great ministries thrive on simple truths. What else came? Wind. God was not in the wind. God appeared in a... Look at this. Which one did we read? Can we read Psalm 90? Yes, I think 90 verse 14. Look at that. Read with me. Come on, go. Oh, satisfy me early with your mercy that we may... let's read it again. Oh, satisfy us early. Somebody mark the word early with your mercy, that we may rejoice and be glad all our days. You want to be glad? You want to rejoice all the days of your life? God should satisfy you, not late. Early. 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 David said in one of the verses in the Psalms, he says, O Lord, you are my God. Read that, get that verse for me. O Lord, you are my God. Early will I seek you. Homework. Didn't I pray for you last time when I was here? Do your homework. Have you found it? They will find it. They will find it. Eh? He says, early will I seek you. Okay, good boy. Two are better than one because they have a good reward for their labor. Clap for the two of them. They have given you a scripture that is not in my notes, free of charge. Let us read that verse again. Oh Lord, you are my God. Early will I seek you. My soul thirsts for you. My flesh longs for you in a dry and thirsty land where there is no water. Early, early will I seek you. Tell your neighbor that, my new neighbor, I've already thought that is what is missing in your life. Are you sure? Early will I seek you. Nobody should rise before you from today. Be the first one to appear at the gate of the day, which is midnight. Stand before God early. Draw mercies for the day. Joy comes in the morning. Are you seeing that? Early you are seeking him. Early in the morning. Early in the morning. I'm giving you more scriptures. Even if I teach this one today, this one I will hammer it until it enters your last stomach. Don't worry, we are going to read the Bible. Which one did we read last apart from this one? It was Psalm 90 verse 14, right? Can you read it for me? Oh, satisfy me. Can you imagine standing at midnight and say, you lift up your hands and say, oh Lord, satisfy me, early with your mercy. Amen. That I may rejoice and be glad all the days of my life. Can Can you imagine standing at the gate of the day, eh, and say, oh Lord, satisfy my household early with your mercy. Look at such a prayer. Eh? Oh, the angels will be clapping their hands. So many of you wake up when the angels have gone back to heaven and you say, by faith, I know they are here. They have gone. They have already left. They took off. You said, where two or three are gathered. Now, when you get to that, that means you are missing a lot. There are two types of presences of God. There is the general presence. God is everywhere. And there is the specific presence where you literally feel him. There. You are fully persuaded that he's there. My daughter Ivana usually say, there are times I can be talking and spiritual stuff. She doesn't know how to say, I feel the anointing. She just, you see her crying, say, Daddy, I feel God. Are you sure? Yes, I feel like he's here. Make your children feel God. After today, your children will start feeling God. Read that verse. Personalize it. Come on, let's go. Oh Lord, satisfy me. Eh? Let us start now. Come on, go. Oh, satisfy me, Ali, with your mercy, that I may rejoice and be glad all the days of my life. Ooh, beautiful, isn't it? Are you blessed tonight? Can I give you four more scriptures? Are you in a position to handle them? Aki. That was Psalm 90. Did we read Psalm 30, verse 5? I think so. Then I want to give you Psalm 119. Psalm 119, verse 147 and 48. Look at that. I rise before the dawning of the morning. And I cry for help. I hope in your word. Stay there. David is trying to teach me something here. That if I want to cry for help, the best time to draw his attention is early, before the dawning of the morning. You know, before the dawning of the morning, what people call morning, 6 o'clock, 5 o'clock, before that dawning of the morning, from midnight, 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, and 3 o'clock, master those hours. Before the dawning of the morning, that is when God can respond to tears, not at 2 in the afternoon. If you want to cry, that is the best time to cry. Clap for God. The best time, I'm showing you now. How many of you want to cry to God? This is the best time. Take your tears there. Read for me. I want to read, to hear you read. I rise and cry for help. Ooh. That one is deep now. Now you want me to go deeper. This is deeper. This is now deep. You want help? You want to God to see your tears? Rise before the dawning of the morning and cry for help. I hope in your word. Give it to me. Give it to me. Let's first read the following verse. Then we'll read another version. Come on. My eyes are awake through the night watches, that I may meditate your word. Ooh. Give it to me from the Message Bible. Now we are going deeper. You want me to go deeper. I was up before sunrise, crying for help, hoping for a word from you. Isn't that deeper now? I've gone deeper. Tell your neighbor, have you seen? He has gone deeper now. The following verse says, I stayed awake all night, doing what? Prayerfully pondering your promise. Ooh. You better clap to the Holy Spirit. Better clap for the Holy Spirit. You are so blessed in Meru. They are going to wonder, what happened to the people of Meru? They discovered a simple secret, basic. People still want complicated revelations. They have left the basics. Give it to me from two versions, the Living Translation, and let us see. Can we read? I rise early before the sun is up. Wait, that tells me, don't allow the sun to rise up before you rise up. This is David speaking to you a big secret. Don't tell me you are tired. How many of you are going to stay awake until midnight? Tonight. Lift up your hand before I command you. Put an alarm on your phone. 57 minutes, 3 minutes to midnight. The phone should be bah, 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 bah. Wake up. Make sure from midnight to one you are talking to God. Amen? You are talking to God. I rise early before the sun is up. I cry out for help and put my hope in your words. I stay awake through the night thinking about your promise. That is the best time to meditate on that powerful promise God has spoken in the Bible. Of healing. You want to be healed of that disease. Amplified. I anticipated. Come on, read for me now. I anticipated the dawning of the morning and cried in childlike prayer. I hoped in your word. Stay there. Childlike prayer. That is when you go to God and talk like a kid. I'm here. Am I not your son? You are my son. Now, it is me and you, Dad. You talk like a baby now. You only permitted to talk like that in early in the morning. Try that at 11. You will receive a slap that will make that you will never forget. These things only work early in the morning. You are supposed to cry like a child. You know, it is so sweet. You don't know what I'm talking about. It is so sweet. I'm a very bold preacher. I'm one of the bold preachers you'll ever meet. But you need to see me when I'm before God. I forget that I'm an apostle. The language alone, if you ever record me, you'll be shocked. I don't talk to God the way people talk. Dear God. No. We talk. I remind him everything he has done from childhood. Before I tell him now you can do this, I align testimonies upon testimonies. And I tell him, I know this one. The Bible says in Isaiah, come and we reason together. It also says, bring your strong reasons. You want this why? You have to learn to talk to God. You don't just tell God, I want you to do this for me, but why? You give him the reason. The reason why prayers, many of them are not answered, is because you take prayer with no reasons. The reason I was once praying for an HIV positive lady in 1994, I went to God and I said, Lord, this girl is sick and I want you to heal her because she's the breadwinner in her family. Two of her siblings are lame. They can't work. Now, when you take her, they don't have parents. That's how I was. That is prayer now. When you take her, who is going to take care of this? God answered my prayer. She got healed and still alive up to now, from 1994. Come, bring your strong reasons. I anticipated. They have given you scripture free of charge, right? So that you make this message deeper. Now you are going to preach it better than me, because some of these scriptures are not in my notes. Come and we reason together, says the Lord. Though your sins, even if you are a diehard sinner, he says, though your sins are like scarlet, they shall be as white as snow. Though they are red like crimson, they shall be as wool. In other words, even a sinner has a chance if he reasons with God. Do you know why Ezekiah was healed? God said to Isaiah, go tell him, put your house in order, for you will surely die. And you have to know who Isaiah is. Isaiah is not these normal prophets on the streets. You talk with a guy who saw the birth of Jesus live 800 years before Jesus was born. Isaiah is not saying a child will be born. He says he's already born. He's seeing it live. Now, such a gentleman, when he's bringing a message to your house, you have to fasten your seatbelt. That is Isaiah for you. He saw the punishment of Jesus 800 years before it came to pass. But look, Ezekiah did not reason with the prophet, because the Bible doesn't say come and we reason with the prophet. But I want to tell you, one day I'll teach you a message on how to touch God. I want to tell you that even the word of a prophet can be overturned if you know how to reason with God. Because what Ezekiah did was to talk to God. He said, the Bible says he turned to his face to the wall and prayed to the Lord. The following verse says, and he said, remember now, even if you stay there. He said, how, oh Lord, I pray, how I walk before you in truth. In other words, I might be a sinner now, but at least let us talk now, Lord. You see, I'm talking to you. Remember. Remember you. Have you remembered, Lord, those days? You have you remembered? Before Isaiah gets to the gate, God has changed his mind. I've remembered. There is power in short prayers. You know, some prayers don't need fasting. Because if a prophet has prophesied this, don't fast. Go to God and reason. Reason. Bring your strong reasons. When? In the morning. Not at 1:30 in the afternoon. One more scripture. Is it one or two? Let me give you two. Okay. Luke chapter 22. Now let's first read Mark chapter 1, verse 35. And we read together. Now I've brought it to the Lord Jesus. Now in the morning, having risen a long while before daylight. Another version says, while it was still dark. This is the one you sing for. Jesus is a mighty God. Now look at his lifestyle. You cannot get the results of a man until you copy his lifestyle. You didn't get. You need to write that down. You can never register the same results that you see in a certain man until you copy his lifestyle. That is how it works. Now, if you want to see the results of Jesus, copy his lifestyle. Are we together? Very early in the morning, while it was still dark, Jesus got up, left the house, went off to a solitary place where he prayed. Give it to me back in the New King James where we started from. Now in the morning, while, let us read it together. Now in the morning, having risen a long while before daylight, he went out and departed to a solitary place, and there he prayed. We are reading up to verse, I think, 40. And Simon and those who were with him searched for him. I've already told you that greatness is lonely. Even the disciples are not allowed. When they found him, they say to him, everyone is looking for you. Stay there now. When you depart to those solitary places, everyone will look for you. The power of attraction comes from that. Don't look for everyone. Develop a culture. Develop a habit. A preacher was asking me in Nairobi, he saw my meetings in Masai Mara. Boy, I've never seen multitudes, people gathered. They were coming 100 kilometers, 150 kilometers. He was asking me, Apostle, what did you tell them? What made them gather? I didn't tell him the answer. I should have told him this, but I didn't tell him. When you learn to be alone, everyone will look for you. Let me tell you, what you are looking for is about to look for you because you are developing a serious habit. When they found him, they said everyone is looking for you. Verse 38, but he said to them, let us go into the next towns that I may preach there also. For this purpose, I have come forth. Verse 39, and he was preaching in their synagogues throughout all Galilee, casting out demons. Jesus never used to make long prayers during the day. There's nowhere in the Bible where Jesus used to have long prayers during the day. The best time for him to pray was when it is dark, before the sun shows up. That is where he drew the power. In fact, his disciples noticed something about him. He said, this man is secret, is prayer at night. Then they came to him when he finished. They said, Lord, teach us to pray. They did not end there. Just as John. They are looking at these two cousins. They have a powerful secret. Just as John taught his disciples. John was a night man. During the day, he was standing on. He wasn't even dressed well. It doesn't matter. Let me tell you, anointing is not in this suit. The power is not in these tangible things. Are we not going to start being spiritual again? We are going to be spiritual after this session. These ones are helping you free of charge. Receive my grace. Can we read this scripture for free? Now it came to pass, as he was praying in a certain place, when he ceased, he was doing what? Praying in a certain place. when he sees that one of these disciples say to him, Lord, teach us to pray as John also taught his disciples. What are they discovering? You see, you saw my book, The Two Levels of Education. Either you learn by instruction or by observation. They have observed two lives here. John and Jesus. Now they are realizing a secret about them is prayer. And most of the times you see Jesus is praying, is alone. Let me tell you, stop taking everyone with you. If you want prayers that are going to give birth to a revival in your life, be a loner. A-lo-na. Now you are talking to, you are listening to an expert in this field. I spent 3 years outside, alone, in the dark, in the bush, every day. No holidays. 3 years alone. I would appear in this bush at 9 o'clock with a jacket, a torch. Are you listening to Apostle Mayanja? A jacket, a torch, and a watch. That is how this ministry was born. Are you listening? And I'll get to this bush. You know, I was remembering the other day, and I was like, I remember how I used to tell the Lord, make me sleep for 3 hours. The moment I would make that prayer, I would just sleep, just there in that bush. Sleep. And I would tell the Lord, wake me up at midnight. At midnight, I would feel hands wrapping themselves around me. And I'd put on the torch. I would look at the clock. It is midnight. And I'll pray from midnight to 6 in the morning for 3 years, nonstop. That was the first time I saw a leopard. I think it had demons that wanted to scare me. I was really scared. And I remember the prayer I made was that, Lord, my life is in your hands. Ask me how old was I. I was 22 to 23 years. I was a young man. I pity the young men of today. So lazy. So lazy. You cannot see the God we have seen being lazy the way you were. I started when I was almost 22. I was still 21. For 3 years. And I would hear great preachers prophesying to me. Even when I'm walking, that young man will be a great man of God. That young man will be a great man of God. Huh? Are you getting it now? So I'm taking you from theory to practicals now. 3 years. When I said, my life is in your hand, it was so bright. There was that moon, it was shining bright. It was, the leopard walked away. The second time I saw a leopard is when I went for holiday in Masai Mara. That was the first time. No, that was the third time because I saw another one in the zoo. I've seen leopard 3 times only. Now hear me. After those 3 years, my life was never the same. It was never the same. Those habits, and you cannot kill them. It has stayed with me. 3 years. During the day, I used to pray for 4 hours. But at midnight to 6, I would stand before God. That is when I saw everything about my ministry, how God wants to use me, how he wants me to reach certain groups of people. He would speak to me so many things. Now you know that I'm not just reading the Bible. I'm talking things that my hands have handled. receive my grace now. When I finished, I went to a certain house. That is where I started praying from after the bush experience. I remember one girl who was working for me asked me, "Man of God, do you want this jacket?" She didn't know the history of the jacket. I had hanged it somewhere. I said, "What about it?" He said, "Why don't you give it to me?" I said, "You want that jacket? I've given it to you." She never stayed in the house for 3 years. Pray. You joke with a jacket that saw a leopard. You will sleep out. Don't just ask for things. I can give you shoes that will make you stay outside. Let me give you the last scripture. I release you. Hallelujah. How many are blessed by the message tonight? Bring somebody here tomorrow. Please bring people. Let them come. Help them. Let them know these things, okay? Tell them we are learning how to be spiritual. We read which verse? We didn't finish. And as he was preaching, verse 40 says, "Now a leper came." I wanted verse 39 only. Let us read Luke chapter 22. Verse 39 to 41. Let us read it together. "Coming out, he went to the Mount of Olives as he was accustomed." Another version says, "as his custom was." In other words, this was a habit. "And his disciples followed him. When he came to the place, he said to them, 'Pray that you may not enter into temptation.'" Are you listening to that? And this is happening when he's about to be crucified. Late in the night. "And he withdrew." He was withdrawn from them about a stone's throw, and he knelt down and prayed. This is Jesus. Give it to me in the Message Bible we finish. The verses. "Living there, he went as he so often did." Read it with me, come on now. "Living there, he went as he so often did to Mount Olives. The disciples followed him." When they arrived at the place, he said, "Pray that you don't give up into temptation." Let me tell you, the easiest way to overcome temptation is prayer. Prayerful people. When you see evil thoughts increasing in your mind, the only thing you can check is your prayer life. Never check anywhere. When you see sin trying to prevail over you, look at your prayer life. Look at your prayer life. Lift up your hands. Heavenly Father, Korasata rekobo sikaba, runda karesi koremanda sikebo yanderebo sata, rokora basanda ramasakato robo sikete rebo sanderebo bo, rukata karamama. I want somebody to lift your voice in 3 minutes. Make a commitment to be an early riser, a person who stand before God to pray. I didn't tell you to walk. Where? You are walking. Never do that again.
Lift your voice. Talk to God. Make a commitment that you will be an early riser. You will be a person. I want to hear this house filled with prayer. Give me the grace. Give me the grace. Give me the grace. Lord, give me the grace. Rakarabu siti ribu saka mama mama mama. Give me that grace. I have heard your servant say, give me the grace. Give me the grace. Give me that grace, God. My heart says, I will seek you. I will seek you. I will seek you. I will seek you. I want to seek your face. Give me that grace. Can somebody get more serious about this? I want to seek you. I commit my spirit. Pray like David. My flesh is longing for you. My flesh is not longing for fame. My flesh is longing. Come on. My soul thirsts for God. Give me that grace. Give me the grace to be that person who is going to stand before you in the wee hours of the morning. I want to be like my Lord Jesus, a person who stands in the presence of God. Oh Lord, you are my God. Only will I seek you. Oh Lord, you are my God. Only will I seek you. Oh Lord, you are my God. I want to stand early in your presence. I commit myself to be the first one to bring the first fruits of my mouth. The first fruits of my mouth. Standing in your presence. I'm standing in your presence. Maroko rabasakata mama mama. Rasakata karabasanda ramama. Teach me, Lord, how to stand. How to stand in your presence when it is still dark. When it is still dark. I have learned your mercies are new every morning. May I be that person who collects mercies, new mercies every morning. Oh, come on. 2 more minutes to go. Do it, do it, do it. Mean every word you are speaking now. Mean it. God is seeing your heart. He's seeing every word you are speaking now. Revival is coming to your families. Revival is coming to your people. An individual revival is happening. Somebody is going to stand before God at midnight. Somebody will stand before God at 2 in the morning. Somebody will stand before God at 3 in the morning. You will stand before God. Your spirituality is increasing. Your spirituality is being boosted. It is being boosted. These are spiritual boosters. We are receiving spiritual boosters. Come on now. Oh.
Shokura baba 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 baba. Rakanda rabasakata baba baba. Rabasekete kerebosaka baba baba. Yikarobusanda raba baba baba. Urabasekere baba baba. Urabasanda raba baba baba. Rukurabasata kata baba. Yorobusete rebosika baba baba ye. May the spirit of revival come upon this house. Revival come on 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 this house. Come on this house. Come on this house. 50 seconds and we finish. Let the Lord hear your voice now. Heavenly Father, touch these pieces of clay with a revival of standing like men in the Bible, like Abraham, who rose very early in the morning to intercede for Sodom and Gomorrah. Let us be like such men, the John the Baptist, the Lord Jesus, the Davids, men who discovered the secret of giving you the first fruits of their lips when it is still dark. I pray that there is going to be a move of God. The families that have listened to me here on the radio, on YouTube. Come on, Holy Spirit. Those who have listened to me on Facebook, let there be revival in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Celebrate Jesus. If you have never watched a message I preached years ago, the power praying at midnight, how many have ever watched that message on YouTube? All right. So many of you have not watched it. Go on YouTube and look for the power praying at midnight by Apostle Mayanja. Your life will not be the same again. Hallelujah. Tomorrow, we are starting from there. Do me a favor. Get someone. We want, by the time we will be finishing this, we will be very spiritual. Our spirituality will be boosted. Glory. Can we give offerings to God? Somebody clap your hands. Clap your hands because we are giving to God. Prepare your offering now. Where is my screens? Ah, yeah, they are here. Sit down and prepare your offering. Kingdom giving is kingdom living. What a word. Look at that platform. There is M-Pesa. You know how to go about the pay bill number, a business number. Is that what? Then accounts, the account, let me read the account number. This is This is for checks, or this is for M-Pesa, the account number for M-Pesa. Beautiful. Follow that procedure. Now there is a platform for checks. Checks. All checks are payable to Great Gospel Visioners International. We are in an international ministry now. Don't forget that. Great Gospel Visioners International. That is when you are signing a check. Okay? But make sure, don't give God what you feel like giving. Give God an offering that is acceptable. Years ago, I taught you a message here called the acceptable sacrifice. I don't know whether it was this building or the other building. The other one. Where was the pulpit? This side? Where was I? Where did I used to stand? Somewhere here. You give offerings that are acceptable. Not every offering is accepted. There are offerings God literally rejects and says, give it to your governor and see whether he will accept it. It is in Malachi. So consider. Somebody say consider. Hey, consider. A guy intimidated me when I was in Standard 4. He was our head prefect. For the first time I heard the word consider, I said, hey, where did he get this one from? Consider. Now also consider when you are giving. Are you done? I'm praying now. Lift up anything you are using, whether phone or fast finish, because I see you with phones, then I pray. Or let me be praying. You go on. Father, in Jesus' name. Every seed has a name. Because the Bible says seeds put on different bodies. I want to give this seed a name by faith. We call it revival in our families. A revival prayer. A revival of standing before God in the morning so that we can receive the mercies of God. Anyone who is giving, satisfy them early with your mercy, oh God. Satisfy them early with your mercy, that they may know that I'm your servant, and by your word I've spoken this in Jesus' name. Amen. We can proceed with our giving right away. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning, new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness, O God. Great is thy
We allow Apostle to have his way. Let's appreciate the Lord for the great ministry we have received. Thank you, sir, for that great ministry. I think we can do better to the Lord for the ministry. We have received that great ministry. Indeed, we are so grateful. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir, for that great ministry we have received. Now we're going to lift up our hands just for 1 minute to give thanks to the Lord for the ministry that we have received. The Lord has empowered us by his word, and that has been very, very powerful and empowering.